हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एल्गा 13 ऑनलाइन रिवीजन क्लास। इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल बी डूइंग रिवीजन ऑफ यूनिट 3। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, यू मस्ट हैव योर स्टूडेंट रीडर, अ नोटबुक एंड पेन और अ पेंसिल। सो वी विल बिगिन विद द फर्स्ट कॉम्पोनेंट, दैट इज होल वर्ड्स। In whole words, we will learn some new words, their meaning and the sentence example. So the first word is self-complaint. Self-complaint meaning is to complain about something to own self. So sentence can be, Rita self-complained about the hot weather. So next word is agreement. Agreement means the situation in which people have the same opinion, means they think same, opinion is same, or in which they approve of or accept something, so they also feel like that. Sentence can be, I was in agreement with my parents that we should go to Kashmir for our holidays. Next word is strange. Strange means unusual and unexpected, or it can be difficult to understand. So sentence can be, it is strange that my money got stolen. Next word is broke the silence. Its meaning is when it is really quiet and someone makes a noise or talks. So sentence can be, Neha broke the silence by announcing that she wants to take admission in Delhi University. Next word is sheepishly. It is meaning is in an embarrassed manner due to shame or lack of confidence when you feel embarrassed. So sentence can be, Kiran smiled sheepishly and said that she had not done her homework. So when we have not done homework, so that time we feel embarrassed also due to shame and you are having lack of confidence. Yes, so today we have learned some new words, their meaning and sentences. So now we'll move ahead to the second component, reading and listening expressions. In reading and listening expression, we learn what is making a judgment. So making a judgment means when we make a decision on what needs to be done about something after thinking carefully. So we will make judgment on solution in the story. Okay, so you all have read Dabki's story. So how would I have solved the problem? So first we'll read that story. You all can read that story again. So we will use this table to make judgment on solution. So first of all, problem, then solution, then other possible solution. So how would you solve this problem? Let's see. Let us see how we can make a judgment using the first story we read, Dabki's school. What was the problem in the story, Dabki's school? You all remember what was the problem? The problem in this story was that Dabki was forced to leave school. Yes, this was the problem, that she was forced to leave school. What was the solution to Dabki's problem in this story? Let's see. The solution was, Mr. Mehta helped Dabki's family. She started going to school again. All her expenses were taken care by Riya's family. After many years, Dabki fulfilled her dream of becoming an engineer. So what were the other possible solutions? The first one was, Dabki's parents can save up money and after a few years send her back to school. This can be the possible solution. सेकेंड सॉल्यूशन कैन बी दब की कैन गो टू स्कूल दैट प्रोवाइड्स फ्री एजुकेशन टू चिल्ड्रन हु कैनॉट पे फीस. सो दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी डन. थर्ड पॉसिबल सॉल्यूशन कैन बी दब की कैन सेव अप मनी एंड आफ्टर फ्यू ईयर्स शी कैन यूज इट फॉर गोइंग टू स्कूल. So how would you solve this problem if you would be in this situation? If someone is not able to give fee and is forced to leave the school, so how would you solve this problem? So you can speak to your principal, school principal, and see if they can give admission for free. Yes? So this is how you can write the answers. With this we have completed a reading and listening expression. Now we will learn some new things in grammar. Children, what do you see in this picture? Just try to see this picture. Which all things you are able to see in this picture? So we can see a boy is climbing a slide. The dog has a carrot in its mouth. Bicycle and other toys are fallen on the path. You all can see. Two children are fighting over a doll. Yes. Then there are flowers of different sizes. And two adults are talking to each other. So we can make some different questions also by using 5 WH words. Yes. So what questions we can make? Who is climbing the slide? Then second question can be, what does the dog has in its mouth? Then whose bicycle has fallen? Whom does the doll belongs to? Then which flower is the biggest? So these all we can frame questions by using WH words. Next we will learn where to use A and where to use an. Read these sentences. I am eating an apple. I am eating a banana. A and an means one of anything that can be counted. It is used when we are not talking about a specific thing. So A, where we use A? When the noun begins with a consonant sound. For example, a horse. When you will speak horse, so the sound of consonant will come. So when the noun begins with the consonant sound, there we use A. Where we use an? When the noun begins with the vowel sound. An elephant. So when we speak elephant, so we hear vowel sound. That's why we write an. Ice cream. Ice cream. A sound is coming. So that's where an is coming. So remember, when the noun begins with the consonant sound, we use a. When the noun begins with the vowel sound, we use an. Now, read the passage carefully. Last night, I saw an owl on a tree. The owl was sleeping. It was a brown owl. I had never seen one before. I went downstairs near the tree. I took a bowl of water with me for the owl. When do we use A and an? When do we use the? Let's see. A and an are used when we are talking about any one thing. And the is used when we are talking about one or more specific things. So when we talk about one of most specific thing, that time we use the. Clear? Using of the. Last night I saw an owl on a tree. The owl was sleeping. It was a brown owl. I had never seen one before. I went downstairs near the tree. I took a bowl of water with me for the owl. So the beginning of the passage tells us about one owl sitting on one tree. It could be any one owl and any one tree. In the next sentence, we use the for the owl, not an. This is because now we are not talking about any owl. We are talking about the specific owl that is sitting on this specific tree. Is that clear? Why is the and a used in the later sentences? So the is used for the tree and owl in the later sentences because we are still talking about the specific owl and tree. A is used for bowl because it could be any bowl of water that I took. Now let us revise what we have learnt in writing and speaking expression. When you are sharing your letters, what do you have to focus on? What will you do to share them well? So when you have to share your letters, so what you will focus on and what will you do to share them well? So what you will do? First thing, make eye contact with the audience and not look at paper much. Don't see and just read. So you have to make eye contact with the audience. Then second thing is stand straight and not move around much. Don't just move and speak. You have to stand straight and then speak. Be loud and clear. So your voice must be audible. You have to be loud and clear, but don't shout. Use hands to explain the letter. So you can use your hand gestures to explain your letter. Use different tones to show feelings in the sentences. So when there is something like joyful, so you must speak like you are very happy, something sad. So the tone, different tones should be used to show the feelings. How to be a good audience. So when you are listening to someone who is speaking his letter, so how you can be a good audience? So first of all, look at the speaker and listen to them. We must look to the speaker and listen them carefully. Do not talk amongst each other. So if somebody is speaking and you're busy talking with your partner, so speaker will lose his confidence. He will think that nobody is paying attention. So we must not talk amongst each other. We should listen to the speaker carefully. Next, do not laugh or make fun of the speaker. So when somebody is speaking or saying something, then we must not laugh and we must not make fun of the speaker. Last, make the speaker feel comfortable by smiling at them. So we must have a smile on our face. We should listen, we should see to the speaker, listen carefully and make the speaker feel comfortable. Okay, clear? With this, we have finished our today's revision.
Thank you students for attending the class. Happy learning.